So Paul, we've talked about potential energy in other sections like stars and planets, but how does potential energy apply to space exploration and travel?
Well, once again, it's mostly gravitational potential energy. And this is a graph of the gravitational potential energy around the Earth. So this down here is the Earth's surface. And you see that as you go up, the energy goes out, but then when you get further and further away, the gravity of the Earth is weaker and weaker, and so it tends to flatten out.
So you need a lot really just to get you going, but as you said, as you get higher and higher, further away from the Earth, you need less.
And once you're up to this amount of energy, which corresponds to escape velocity, you can kind of go anywhere. So getting you the first 100 kilometers up or the first 1,000 is quite hard, but by the time you're at a few tens of thousands of kilometers, it gets easier and easier.
Now, if we didn't have enough energy, as you said, with escape velocity, we'd kind of be stuck on that infinity roller coaster, we would fall back towards the Earth. We don't escape the gravitational pull of the Earth.
Yes, so as we talked about for the orbits, you can get up to, say, part way up, and then get enough sideways speed to keep yourself
That's right.
there. So this diagram that I showed you there is like a one-dimensional cut through it, but in reality it's three-dimensional. So
That's
if you
right.
have the Earth here, the energy will go up in this direction, and that direction. I can't show that, but I can show it in two
It's
dimensions.
better than it's nothing.
So you get some sense. This would be a nice golf hole.
It really would be.
Make
It would be a
things.
big hole, though.
It'll make it much easier to get things in, since gravity of
There
the hole sucked it all in.
Well, there you go. Maybe you should redesign golf courses in the shape of gravitational potential
For
energy.
people challenged with golf like myself. Now, that was just the Earth. Let's try adding in the Earth and the Moon. Now, this is not to scale. To scale, it looks like this, but we'll come back to that in a second.
Yes.
So, but the basic idea is you've got the Earth's surface and you've got the Moon's surface.
And the moon, we kind of know, is going to be smaller than the Earth, less massive, less dense, as we talked about in the planet section.
That's right. So, this is showing the basic idea, but in reality, if you do it properly to scale, the Earth is a lot more massive
I
than the
mean, this
Moon.
is, I mean, here to that. I mean, that's a
I mean,
pretty
the
big
Earth weighs
difference.
10 times more than the Moon,
Yep.
so you'd expect it to be 10 times bigger gravitational potential. It's even worse than that because the Earth is also much denser,
That's right.
so our surface is lower in the potential curve. So, in fact, it's more than a factor of 10 difference between the Earth and the Moon.
So there's a huge jump to get from here to here, as opposed to the kind of this same spot just to leave that moon potential.
So, an obvious consequence of this is you're going to need a lot more rocket fuel to get from Earth to the Moon than to get from the Moon to the Earth. And we can see that. So, here, for example, is a spacecraft going from the Earth to the Moon.
The Saturn V, that's right, the biggest rocket built.
And as you can see, there's rather a lot of chemical energy being used there.
And so all of that chemical energy was stored potential energy before.
The chemical energy is being converted into kinetic energy and into potential energy by
Yep.
pushing it up. But now, if you look at launching from the Moon,
It's a lot smaller.
there's a whole lot less fuss here. I mean, generally speaking, when it takes off, you're not seeing billowing flame, not even seeing
It's
huge
kind of
fuel tanks.
uneventful almost. It kind of looks like someone just gave it a giant kick.
Flick upwards. And that's because of this potential curve.